over 36.7 million people living with HIV and AIDS. The funny thing about it is that it tends to wipe out the productive sector. The young people, ages 15 to 49, that is the age group that is most affected. And I would like you to know that Grenada is not exempt from the HIV epidemic. Currently, the figures are trending upward, like it is in all the other countries in CARICOM.
Politicians in Grenada. I know some folks are green and some folks are yellow and some folks are looking towards politicians. But ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you about a man called Jesus this evening, because Jesus makes all the difference. Now I want to present you two scenarios where Jesus came into the city. The Bible says in the book of Luke chapter 13, a wonderful situation here. Luke chapter 13, and no, and we have a few Bibles still left giving away, so you can get your Bible and get it and read it one time. But in Luke chapter 13, from verse 11, the Bible talks about a woman who was in real problems for 18 years. Now that's a long time. For 18 years, this lady had an infirmity. She had a problem, a physical problem, a health problem. And I'm assuming that she went to many doctors, many health fairs, and many counseling sessions, and nothing worked, ladies and gentlemen. But when before she met Jesus, her situation was hopeless. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm saying before that lady met Jesus, her situation was hopeless. That may have been said to her by her doctors and her nurses and the health professionals. But then she met with Jesus. In Luke chapter 13, I'm reading, you're hearing verses 11, 12, and 13. The Bible says, "And behold, there was a woman which had a spirit of infirmity for 18 years." That's a long time. "And was bowed down and could no wise lift herself up." So if you see me, the woman was bent over for 18 years. She was crouched down and she had to go to the beach like that. She had to go to church like that. She had to go to the garden like that. Bent down for 18 years and nobody could help her. Nobody. Now that's a very compromising situation to be in. But something happened in your life. But verse 12 says, "And when Jesus saw her," I know Jesus is seeing somebody here this afternoon. The Bible says, "When Jesus saw her, he called to her and said unto her, Woman!" Jesus saw this woman who was bent over. Sin has bent her over. He said to her, "Woman, thou art loose." And immediately, the Bible says in verse 13, and Jesus laid his hands upon her. And immediately she was made straight and she glorified God. Said, this evening, I'm recommending Jesus to everybody this afternoon.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there is something big, something great, something, you know, of more magnitude to hit God. And what we've given you here is just a taste. Get ready, it's coming. A big family event, a big activity that everybody must. be part of, and is coming up with a gospel explosion with internationally renowned evangelist, revivalist, speaker, Claudius Morgan. And he's going to be here with us right here in Guam. And I guess you have heard about it, but we are giving you more information and we are encouraging you to be with us. It starts on the 4th of June, the 11th rather of June, and you've got to be there. Make sure transportation is organized, and of course you will get more information as the date draws closer. You want to hear more gospel singing, more head screening, more Bibles given out, you know, and you're going to hear, it's going to be exciting. You cannot afford to miss it. Guam will be the hottest place to be on the 11th. So get ready, Guam. Get ready. As a matter of fact, the whole of Grenada will be there. So Guam, don't miss out. It's coming your way, and you've got to be there.